turned you on to wrestling?
I started watching wrestling with my grandmother in her basement when I was about 8 or so.
Yeah.
And it was great because, you know, it was like the holy triumphant in Winnipeg. You'd watch Roadrunner, Bugs Bunny, then you'd watch wrestling, and then you'd watch Hockey Night in Canada. So my grandmother was really, like, she was really quiet and reserved, but when she ever watched, she watched wrestling, she would start to really lose it, and she hated the bad guys.
Yeah.
So she'd be really quiet, and then she'd be like, I want you to get him! Get him! Come on! He's cheating! He's cheating! And then she'd go sit down again.
That's great.
That's not fair. That referee needs glasses.
And then your grandmother was all into like the bad guys. Like the bad guys would stir her up.
Well, yeah, she didn't like the bad guys. So now my grandmother's probably not very happy with me right now, being the bad guy. I'm like the big bad guy.
But you know what?
My grandmother's like, you stop it, Chris. Stop cheating.
I think she'd be proud of you, man. From sitting there watching wrestling with your grandmother to actually being a world wrestling champion and being a bad guy, I think is the greatest tribute to your grandmother.
Right.
You know?
Thanks to my grandma.
Yeah. So, this is what's crazy, because I know comedians work their way up, but wrestling, you had, like, private gigs as a wrestler back in Canada, right?
Well, like, when you first start, you work wherever you can, you know, you drive 300 miles for $15 or for nothing or whatever, but the worst one I had was I had to wrestle in a Quonset, which is kind of like a barn that they put wheat in at a kid's birthday party. So, yeah, this kid had his own ring, and he had wrestlers come over, and it's like, man, when I was a kid, I got Kedzo the Clown. This guy gets 3 matches plus ring entrances, you know. So we worked the match, and it was freezing outside, and all the moms were there with their mom jeans, you know, pulled up to here and watching, like, oh, it's like Chippendales on ice. These guys are so hot. And, you know, so it's freezing, and at the end of this, like, well, at least maybe we'll get something for it. We end up getting paid a hot dog and a glass of orange juice. So that was, yeah, it was good. Not bad, right?
You didn't get any money, you got a hot dog.
Nothing. Hot dog and a glass of orange juice. No ketchup, no mustard.
This is
no
also
condiments.
This is also what I love. I love Lucha Libre. When I was a kid, I watched Lucha Libre all the time, right? With the masks and.
Yeah.
But you wrestled in Mexico, Lucha Libre, and usually it's the other way around that Mexican wrestlers come here. But you went to Mexico.
Yeah, I was in Mexico, and my name was Corazón de León.
We have a picture, wait a minute.
Heart of a Lion.
Look at that. Bro, that's crazy.
Look at that package on the bottom there. Look at this, like the worst banana hammock tights you could ever wear. It's like I'm smuggling a grapefruit.
But that was your real outfit?
That was my real outfit,
Lionheart, Corazón de León.
Corazón de León, there you go. And when people didn't like me, you'd hear someone go, Corazón de Pollo.
Okay, so you leave tonight to Arizona. Good luck.
Yes.
Good luck to
WrestleMania.
Fozzy. Go see Fozzy.
Yes, Fozzy. WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Big pay-per-view.
WrestleMania 26. Here. Live on pay-per-view this Sunday, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 o'clock Pacific. Corazón de León. Chris Jericho.